Good evening, everyone. This is Tube 87. I just wanted to stop by this evening and do a quick video in response to a question I was asked. And simply put, the question I was asked was, what scriptures say that the woman's responsibility is to raise the children? And that kind of struck me as odd because I had never thought about that being a question. I presumed that it was obvious to us all that the woman's responsibility, according to the word, is to raise the children, and the man's responsibility is to work hard and provide, because that's part of the principles of what scripture is about. But being that I never looked at it that way, I said, okay, well, what scriptures say that? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to point at a couple of scriptures and expound upon what it's saying and really just cite or make reference to just tons of examples given to us in scripture of what the men do and what the women do, because that's really what scripture is littered with, example after example of who's doing what. But go with me to Genesis 3, and we're going to go to Genesis 3:16. Now, 3:16 reads, it says, "Unto the woman he said, I will greatly multiply thy sorrow and thy conception. In sorrow thou shalt bring forth children, and thy desire shall be to thy husband, and he shall rule over thee." Now, the father told Eve that in sorrow she's going to bring forth children. Now, this was because of what? Because of the transgression, because of the sin. So this was going to be her plight, to bring forth children. Now, if she brings forth children, she's going to raise them. I mean, just, you know, he didn't say, you're going to bring forth children and Adam's going to raise them. But he was clear. He said, this is going to be your plight. You, in sorrow, you're going to bring forth children. And then turned right around to Adam and said to him in verse 19, he says, "In the sweat of thy face shalt thou eat bread till thou return unto the ground. For out of it wast thou taken, for dust thou art, and unto dust thou shalt thou return." And then in verse 23, he tells Adam, he says, "Therefore the Lord God sent him forth from the Garden of Eden to till the ground from whence he was taken." Now, he told him he's going to eat bread. And then in 23, he told him he's going to till the ground. Well, obviously, he's going to till the ground to grow whatever they're going to eat. Now, right there in just those couple of verses, it's giving us right there an example of what their responsibilities are going to be. Now, Eve's going to bear children that she's going to raise, and Adam is going to go out here and sweat and work to provide for that family, to provide the bread that they're going to eat. Now, obviously, as a family unit, there's a lot of interacting, but the father was laying out their primary responsibilities or their primary plight because of their transgression, and they were to go forth and populate the world. So if you look at Genesis 4:2, we're talking about Abel. It says, Genesis 4:2, it says, "And she again bare his brother Abel, and Abel was a keeper of sheep, but Cain was a tiller of the ground." So in that scripture right there, we're being told once again a couple of things that the men are doing. Abel is a sheep herder, and Cain, as Adam, they're going to be working the fields. These are their responsibilities. This is what they're going to be doing. And then Noah is told in, if we go to Genesis 9:20, it says, "And Noah began to be an husbandman, and he planted a vineyard." Now, there's a reference to an husbandman, and it takes us right back to Genesis 4:2, where it says, a keeper of sheep and a tiller of the ground. Now, because we were talking about Noah's making reference to what Noah was doing, he was doing the same thing. He was keeping his herds and working the fields. So it's being laid out what the men are doing, and naturally the women are taking care of the home. It's not that, look, here's the thing. A lot of the changes in our society have come about in recent years, but I never thought about that some of you are not even old enough to remember when really that was the case. Now, it's become taboo or chauvinistic or un-PC thing to say that a woman's place is at home, taking care of the home and the children. Because nowadays, women have been trained and conditioned to not want to hear that. Women have been trained and have been changed in their thinking to really believe that they want to be out there working just as hard as men, making money just like men and all these things. Now, really think about this. How many of you women would not love to be at home or would have just been at home raising your children and taking care of your home and your husband out there making the money, bringing it home, and everything's fine on that front, and he comes home and you're a happy family and he's the enforcer of what you've laid down when he comes home, and just go like that. Instead of everybody working, no one has time, everyone's passing each other, not having time to spend with one another, the children are raising themselves, and then we wonder why there's so much chaos in the home. But because this world has become so politically correct and doing the right thing with the help of the enemy, it has been flipped to doing right is evil. See how it works? How you can't dare tell a woman that your place is at home, taking care of the home and raising kids. You be ready for a fight. That's how it works now. The enemy has done a good job at that. But the younger generations, that's all they know anyway, is that, hey, the women know, hey, I want to get out there and make money and buy my own house and all these things. And that's great, because that's what the enemy wants us to think. That's how he wants us to think. But a lot of us understand, and we come from families where mom stayed at home, maybe worked part-time or whatever. It wasn't so bad, but she was home, taking care of the home and raising us, and dad was out working and doing these things. And a lot of our family survived just fine. But now everyone wants to be financially secure. Everyone wants their own $30,000 car. Everyone wants their own $200,000 home, and it's out of control. But look, just quick and to the point, really, scripture is full of examples of what the women did and what the men did. And that's basically what it was all about. But people don't know this anymore, and they definitely aren't being taught this anymore. This is a father separation and deception created by the enemy to destroy family. That's why people can't get married and stay married anymore, and that's why children are having so many problems, because there's no one home raising them. Everyone's out and just presuming the kids are mature enough and old enough to raise themselves. And for those who are old enough and mature enough to raise themselves, what do? We take our little children, our babies, toddlers, and infants, and we drop them off at other facilities, daycare providers, and public schools. Remember, parents used to teach their own children. It's called homeschooling. Hello, some people still do that. But we dump them off on other agencies nowadays, and we hope for the best, because that's all you're doing is hoping for the best. If you're not raising your kids and instilling what's right in them and what's required, someone else is doing it, and there's no telling what someone else is doing. We see it in the news every day, and we never know what they're doing to our children. There is nothing wrong with a woman staying at home, taking care of her home, making it beautiful, making her castle beautiful, raising her kids, making them wonderful, obedient children, and providing for her husband. And he brings it home and he's happy and he's like, here, baby, I love you. This is great. We're happy. But see, the enemy's flipped all that. Anyway, with that being said, remember, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. This is 2 of Base 7. I'm out.